prideful in the preaching of the reign of God. There is one particular ministry that has alleviated hunger and suffering on our island, a service founded by the late Irish Bowman in 1989, and today sanctioned by our very own a well-known reality that the ELCA is one of the widest denominations in the country, with 96% of their membership being of European descent. So the call of pastor of color certainly takes some courage, certainly takes this ability to listen carefully to the Holy Spirit. And you consider this, in 1988, the ELCA created the goal to increase its membership with people of color by 10%. Nearly 40 years later, that number remains slightly unchanged. Do you understand how unlikely it is to have a pastor of color in the LCA congregation? Do you know how uncommon it is to have a person of color in an LCA congregation on a Sunday morning? If you're a person of color in this room, please know that you matter. You have great value in the eyes of God and in this congregation. And you are making the decisions of the body. Racism and white supremacy exists in our society in many forms, baked into all kinds of things, even in the church, including in the ELCA. It's lamenting, it's saddening to see the silence and the complicity that permeates within the church with little accountability. Thank you.
crescendo, it begins to stay in a pessimistic attitude, to demean others behind their back, judgmental people, tend to be insecure of themselves, and therefore condemn their insecurities of inadequacy to be the middle of others. Power driven, grounding everything on their own idiosyncratic values, preferences, and tastes, because it's about me. God's kingdom is such.